grab it here. So now we're going to install Ubuntu server on one of the servers. I put a link down in the description to where you can download the ISO for the operating system. And the way I did it is I have a CD drive that has a USB connection. And I just put it in there and then connected the drive to the server and booted up the server, and then it started loading from the CD-ROM without any further ado. So anyway, let's have a look at the installation. Okay, here goes with the installation, so I'll start the server. I'll only have the sound on when I need to say something because it's going to be a bit loud. Well, so far so good. As you hear, it's a bit loud. I'll just have to continue. Well, this is taking rather a long time. I mean, it did recognize the network interfaces and even gave the IP address for the one that was connected to the network. So I don't know why this is... Oh, fine. Oh, looks like we have an installed operating system. So anyway, now after the installation's done, I'll log into the physical console, connect it to the server first, and then check for what's the IP addresses assigned to your interfaces. So that's using the command network ctl status. I got all the commands that I'm going to be commenting there in the comments, so you can just copy paste them from there. And once you got a hold of the IP address, then you can go into PowerShell and then you can issue a command ssh/l with the username and then the IP address of the server. And then you just enter the password. So now we're in. Well, it actually shows what it looks like when you run this network control status. So here you can see the status of all the network interfaces you have configured on the machine. Anyway, I'd just like to walk through a few of the steps that one can, or I would suggest one would do. And as I said, the command sequences are in the comments. So anyway, the first thing to do is to check your disk space usage. So then we use the disk free /h, which means human readable. So you get the list of all the mounted drives or mounted devices. Now, if you look at this list very carefully, you'll very soon notice that actually it's not using up all the disk space that we had available in the default volume. And this is because when you install Ubuntu server, it basically takes only 200 gigs for the root. So the first activity is to actually expand the volume so that you actually get enough all the disk space in use. So I'll just sort of a little bit show them. As I said, all the commands are in the comments, but scan all the volumes that are available. So, basically it's kind of simple because in this server configuration we only have one volume. But you can actually see what it's called. And then there's another command you can use to list. It's this one. It does basically the same thing but has a little bit more details. Now you know the volume group name, then you can actually get its status. So here you can see, and I've actually already reconfigured the server. So you see that the allocation and the free space is the free space is much less than what you would see, because I've already done this actually. So basically, when you it's actually not that difficult to do this. So You have a command to basically grab more space from the free volume. So it's called the LV extend slash L, and then you can give a size either here in terabytes or gigabytes, and then you can actually say what volume you. Okay, and after that you need to actually expand the actual disk space after you grab the additional space from the volume. Let's see. So here's the command that you can use to resize the actual file system. So it will consume the whole the new additional free space that it was given. I don't really understand why it has to be two different commands. I couldn't have just integrated them. There's probably maybe a command where you can integrate the two actions in one. and then you can basically do this same. And then you will actually see this in the actual situation that I have now, where you see that the root mounted root has been expanded to 1.9 terabytes. So that's a useful procedure to do. So you don't wonder why you're lacking this bit. The next thing is to look at updates. So there is a way to apply updates manually if you'd prefer to do that. So here's the main. You start with that one, and then you have to issue one more command. Which is that one. But it gets a bit tedious after a while. So I would suggest that you enable automatic updates. And there's actually a package you can download to help you do that. So it's it's this package, unintended upgrades. So you run this first, and then it might actually be already installed on the system. So, but give it a try. It'll actually check if there's a newer one available online. Also, and then you need to configure it. That's only a one-liner. Nothing really amazing. So it's this command you issue, and then it'll pop up with a text interface where you have to answer yes. And after that, you have it will automatically be checking for updates all the time in a low priority. And the next thing to do would be to at least most people I think would want to set up some kind of a shared disk. Or a shared area on the server, so you can access it from Windows. And that is done by installing a tool or package. So it's the Samba package that does that functionality. And what you do is you create a folder. And then you make sure you have the correct access rights for it. And then you edit a specific configuration file where you actually give it the name of what is it going to be called when you're sharing. And then you reboot the service, and then you allow the service to communicate through the software firewall. And then you need to also set a special password for the user when it's connecting to this share. I didn't want to go through all the commands. They're in the comments. So if you want to set up a shared copy paste or take the command examples from the comments. So anyway, that kind of wraps it up for the main activities: fixing the disk space, setting up automatic updates, and then creating a share. And so that's for the basics. Anyway, I thought hope you found this informative. Please consider subscribing, hit the like button. Merch is available. If you'd like to buy me a cup of coffee, links are in the description. And I'll see you in the next one.